we know Memphis is blessed with a number of organizations working to help victims of domestic violence.
That's right, but one also focuses on learning more about the causes and warning signs while it counsels the abuse. Now, the Athena Project is a part of the University of Memphis Psychology Department, and it works to help women regain their strength. Now, joining us this morning is Dr. Gail Beck with the Athena Project, and to let us know a little bit about what the mission of the Athena Project is. What's the mission?
The Athena Project is a mental health research clinic for women who've experienced intimate partner violence and abuse. We know that this type of trauma can leave people with some fairly notable mental health issues, which really are barriers to sort of putting a healthy life together afterwards.
So, well, how exactly do you guys help them out?
Well, we start off with a really thorough mental health assessment because everyone's a little bit different, and we believe that treatment is most effective when it's tailored for her specific needs. So the assessment takes a really deep dive in terms of what's going on with her. We then make treatment recommendations. We have a treatment program that focuses on post-traumatic stress disorder, and if that's appropriate, we'll offer that to her. And if other things are a better fit, we will help her to get those other resources.
And what's great about this is that it is free. It's free services. Now, you are collecting data, but this is all under privacy. The data that you do collect out of this research, what do you do with that information?
Well, the focus on domestic violence as a mental health trauma is relatively new, I would say, within the last 5 to 10 years. So we've actually been publishing quite a lot on what the emotional consequences of intimate partner violence are.
Is it hard sometimes to get women to come in and ask for this help? Because I would imagine a lot of them are ashamed, they feel embarrassed, and they probably don't know how to ask for that help, right?
You just hit on an incredibly important part of this. There's an immense amount of shame and embarrassment that surrounds having experienced intimate partner violence. And even though we know that between 1 in 3 and 1 in 4 women will experience this during their lifetimes, most people don't know that. And so we do a whole lot of outreach. We do a whole lot of public education just to let people know what domestic violence is and what resources are available.
What are some of the warning signs? So say if you're in a relationship but you think something is just not right, what are just a few of the signs? We know a lot of people are different, but what are a few overall signs?
One of the early warning signs is sort of an increasing amount of control from your partner and isolation from friends and family. So what I mean by control is, well, it takes you 20 minutes to drive home from work. If you're 25 minutes late, I'm going to ask you what you did, right? Sometimes that extends to control over finances, control over who you can spend time with. That kind of
going thing. Through your cell phone, taking your car keys, taking your credit cards, things like that. We've
exactly.
seen those kinds of signs all too often. So you've been running this project since 2009, mm-hmm. correct? And there is a summit coming up. Talk a little bit about that and how that can help women in the area going through this stuff.
One of the things that we hear a lot from women who come into the Athena Project is they don't know about this tremendous web of resources in the city. Which is kind of astounding to me. But I also understand because there's no real connection between some of these different agencies. So quite by happenstance, I encountered a colleague and now a close friend who's at the Southwest Tennessee Community College. And we decided to start this domestic violence summit as a way to let people know what the resources are and reduce some of that stigma a little bit.